and how to apologize for those offenses. Interesting question, yeah. We don't know we're doing opera, but we have a way. Thus, we have to be very careful, that's all. One time, one devotee said, oh, Prabhupada, when I chant Hare Krishna, I just go into oblivion. Brother, that is not Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness means to become aware of everything. So most of the time, we're just dull-headed. We're just walking around and committing offenses we don't even know. So become enlightened. Always be conscious. But like we saw, everything, even probably the slightest motion that Prabhupada did was always so sweet, deliberate. He was always completely aware of everything that was going on. And how do we beg forgiveness? Therefore, every morning after the 10 offenses, we always say, Banjara Kalpatra Vasjara Kripasandhuvedita. We beg all the Vaishnavas for any unknown offenses. What is the root cause of offenses? Well, the root cause of being in this material world, envious of Krishna. If we're envious of Krishna, we're envious of his devotees. But the very fact that we're in this material world means we've committed some sort of offense. Vaishnavas are most merciful. Why is it so difficult to be mercy siddha? We're thinking it's difficult, but actually we're all sitting here in this beautiful temple only by mercy of Srila Prabhupada. So it's not so difficult. Everything we have, whatever stage of advancement we're on, it's all by Prabhupada's mercy and by the mercy of the Vaishnavas. Seems difficult, seems like a long time, but from the point of view of eternity, it's just a snap. We may think, just like Vasudeva and Devaki, they never thought, oh, why Krishna's taking so long to save us? In front of their eyes, you know, 6 children were killed in front of their eyes. Went on, that means for years and years they were stuck in prison. They never thought, oh, why Krishna's not being merciful to us? You know? The 6 years, that is nothing. This is our problem. We're just seeing from our tiny perspective. We don't see from Krishna's perspective. With this one tiny 100-year, not even 100-year lifetime. Mm-hmm. Prabhupada said, if you follow these 4 regular principles, you chant Hare Krishna 16 rounds and you will go back to home, back to Godhead. And I was sitting in LA and Prabhupada said, I guarantee it. And all the devotees went, Jai! And Prabhupada looked around and said, I guarantee it. So the process is guaranteed. Huh? Not only that, Prabhupada's giving his discount. One time in Melbourne, the previous temple, not the one they have now, the previous temple, they had a huge vyasa, very tall, many steps up. And Prabhupada gave one of those lectures that if you have even tiny material desire in your heart, lesh matra, then you will not go back to home, back to God. Whole lecture was harping on this point. If you have any type of material desire, slightest material desire, you will not go back to home, back to Godhead. And all the devotees went. So Prabhupada got up from the Vyasada and he saw the faces of the devotees, hopeless. So he took one step down. He said, even if you're 90% Krishna conscious, you will go back to home. So he went, Jai. Prabhupada took another step down. He said, even 80%. The devotees went, Jai. Prabhupada took a third step, 75%, but no less. So process is guaranteed that we're getting 25% this year. How to please Krishna the most? Krishna says in the same nectar devotion, that person who says he's my devotee, I don't know who he is. But that person who says he's a devotee of my devotee, he's actually my devotee. So you want to please Krishna somehow, you find some devotee who's spreading Krishna consciousness and help him. last one.
Last.
How can we clean the offense which we have committed in the morning? Like I said, every morning we just bow down before all the Vaishnavas, the Vanchakalpa Jubasag, Yubasindavavita, Jitanam Bhavanidu, Vaishnavi. Within our hearts we beg forgiveness to all Vaishnavas. So, anyway, in Barsana, there's a place called Chiksoli, right next to Barsana. And just after you go through this village of Chiksoli, you come to a very beautiful place called Krishnakud. One time, Krishna was herding his cows and there was no water. So he took his flute and he dug out this kund with his flute. So Krishna's flute is very practical for calling cows, for calling gopis, for digging kunds. Vandarvani dug a well, Venupoop. Very practical. And there you'll find the asan of Mother Mangal. Because what happened, Chiksoli is very famous for butter, milk, yogurt, ghee. And we know that Krishna, he likes too much. So he came there with all the cowher boys looking for a house where no gopi was home. So they peeked through the window, they saw one house where no gopi was home. So in village life, in old days anyway, we never used to put dogs. So they all came in the front door and they began to drink all the milk and eat all the butter. So that gopi came home, she heard some noise from the window and she peeked inside and saw what was going on. So she went around to the front door and she put the bolt from the outside. Means whoever inside, now he can't get outside. And she ran to call all the other gopis. We caught this rascal red-handed. But Krishna, he also heard that sound. He knows the meaning of that sound. So he looked all around. He went out the window. So all the cowboys, they all ran. They jumped up and bing, bing, bing. They all jumped out the window. But there's one friend of Krishna named Mother Mangal. The first thing is that Mother Mangal, he's lame. So he couldn't run like the other cowboys. He couldn't climb like the other cowboys. Anyhow, he got to the window. Anyway, he got up to the window. He tried to go through. The other problem is that Mother Mangal's, he may be one of Krishna's sakhas, one of his friends, but he's not a gopa. He's a?
Brahman.
And our Braj Brahmas don't tend to be very skinny fellows. If you want to do Brahman Bhojan in Braj, you have to have at least 10 Deshi Ghee Laddus sitting on the plate. They won't even sit down. I can only finish 3, so I'm not a real Brajvasi yet. But they don't see 10, they won't see. We'll just make a puri and everything else. That does mean 10 Deshi Ghee Bundi Laddus there. So they don't tend to be very skinny fellows. Except for our pujari of Vrindavan. So anyway, he got to the window. When he tried to go through, he got stuck. So all the gopis came home, they opened the door, they came inside, ha, we got you. And nobody's there, just this fat friend of Krishna's friend. So they pulled him out of the window, they took flower garlands and tied his hands behind his back. They took a string and they tied it around the sika and threw it over the branch of the tree. Said, now we got hostage. He thought this hostage taking was a new thing. This is going on for the last 5,000 years, at least. So when you have hostage and you have some demand, right? So they told Mother Mangal, now you call your friend Krishna here. And they pulled on that string. Spot. He saw what was going on, he became very angry. Alright, what have you girls done? Don't you know? He may be one of my sakhas, one of my friends, but he's not a gopa, he's a Brahman. Now you're done, Brahman Aparad. Now your health, your wealth, and your beauty will all be finished. And what do little girls worry about? Health and wealth and beauty. So they all became very frightened. So Shyamsundar, what can we do? How do you get free? So Krishna thought for a moment. He said, you make a nice asan for Madhamangal. You sit him down. You go to your houses. You find out as many laddus as you have in your house. You give those laddus to Madhamangal. He'll forget all about the aparad. He will give you ashirvad. So they sat Madhamangal a nice asan. They went to the houses. They brought back all those laddus. Madhamangal was eating those laddus. He became very happy. He gave them all ashirvad, whatever was their manokamana. Manokamana means dear most desire in the heart. And what is the dear most desire in the heart of all the gopis? That Krishna become pleased with them. And that is Krishna consciousness, Sanchet Rukmai. Everything we're doing, we're chanting our rounds, we're following principles. Why? So Krishna will become pleased with us. We associate with devotees, we offer our food, we go to Mangalarti, Kalista, Jamastami, Gopurnima. Why? Just so Krishna will become pleased with us. That is Krishna. Whatever you do, you think, I'm doing this so Krishna will become pleased with me. In fact, you just keep that formula in your mind. Whatever you do, you think, am I doing this so Krishna will become pleased? Or am I doing this so my senses will become pleased? Then you're always Krishna conscious. Simple. We make it complicated, but it's simple. So now Madhamangal's belly is full of laddus. He's very happy. Whatever benediction you want, you take. Sri Madhamangal ki jai. So we have two books with us. Madhuri Karamini, which is the whole, this whole course, rejuvenation, is from Madhuri Karamini, from Shraddha to Prem. So that we have back there by Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur. It's in English, 100 rupees. And we also have Rajlila Part 2, which we inaugurated here in Noida a couple of months ago before we left on our tour. So we have that, that's 300 rupees. So backside you can get, and I have a pen here I can sign. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
His great Deen Bandhu Prabhu ki!
Jai!
Lila Prabhu Pad ki!
Jai!
आप सभी के विहार पर प्रभु जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं. इनके चरण कमलों में तीन बार
हरि बोल, हरि बोल, हरि बोल.